This movie shows an animated burndown chart showing the progress made on the North Dakota production loader project. I'll start by showing the end. The chart here shows several pieces of data. Time goes along the bottom, with the project starting on July 22nd and ending on November 17th. At the time this movie was made, the project was essentially complete. Final testing is being done, and deployment to the production environment is scheduled for November 20th. The vertical axis is shown in units of complexity points. The team breaks a project down into stories, each of which is estimated using a scale of tiny, small, medium, or large. Each of these is twice the size of the previous one and has a point value: 4 for tiny, 8 for small, 16 for medium, and 32 for large. The green bars show completed stories. The orange line shows total points. This line goes up as we add or estimate new stories, and only goes down when the customer decides to cut stories from a release. The red line shows remaining work, the total minus the completed. In this view at the end of the project, you can't really see one of the most interesting and useful planning indicators, which I call the velocity or estimated finish lines. Let's go back to a burndown from the middle of the project so we can see these more clearly. At this point in the project, we had completed 464 points and had 420 points left to complete. The spreadsheet that generates this chart calculates several versions of velocity. Velocity is a number that expresses in complexity points per day how fast the team is moving. Instantaneous or one-day velocity varies quite a bit, so that isn't very useful. Instead, we calculate several different velocities. The first velocity number is the three-day moving average. It adds up the number of complexity points completed over the past 3 days and divides by 3. There is also a 5-day moving average velocity and an overall project average velocity. These velocity values are used to project various possibilities for when the project may be complete, based on the knowledge the team has to date. Here we see the green line projecting a finish date based on the 3-day velocity, the gray line showing the finish date based on the 5-day velocity, and the brown line showing a projected finish date based on the overall average velocity. Now, let's go back to the beginning of the project. We started with a release planning meeting. This project was somewhat similar to a previous project, so we started by creating story cards that were copies of the stories from the previous project. Our customer also added in some new features, and the team added some technical stories of things in the development environment they wanted to improve. After creating the stories, the team estimated the initial set of stories that would be required just to get the project set up and running. Things like getting the version control system set up, an automated build in place, etc. Many teams call this phase iteration zero. While work progressed, we also knew that we had not done enough estimating of the remaining stories. During the next 2 weeks, we had two more release planning meetings where we estimated the remaining stories. At the end of the 2 weeks, we had estimated all the stories we had created, and we also felt that we had created most of the stories we were going to need. At this time, we could do our first estimate of a potential release date. The team's velocity was fairly low, and there was a great deal of work to be done, so the projected release date was very far in the future. Off the chart, in fact. So, the team met with all the project stakeholders, prioritized all the features. We then cut some of the lowest priority features, including many of the technical stories, in order to bring the release date closer to what the business wanted. At this point, the team started focusing on development work, leading to a strong increase in velocity. This is the first time that we saw the average velocity finish line get to zero sometime near the end of November, which we now know was the actual finish date. From here until the end of the project, the average velocity finish line consistently showed a finish date between October 25th and November 25th, with most predictions falling in the first 10 days of November. As is common with many software projects, the end date was later than this due to factors such as bugs being discovered late in the project, allowance for some time at the end for final testing, and a deployment window. We have found that tracking progress using the burndown chart has proven to be extremely beneficial to the team and our business as a whole. It has helped us to see where the project is, where we are going, and make course corrections along the way.